as we make our way through our class story, sorry, origin story, in Star Wars The Old Republic, we pick up a motley crew of 5 companions, but only one of them, usually the first to join us, has a quest that we can actually do. They all have dialogue, and some will even leave the ship to take care of some personal business or other, but usually we can't go along. And that's too bad, because some of that personal business sounds like stuff we'd love to poke our noses into. So here are 5 companions we wish had quests. And beware, there will be some spoilers for companion stories. Elara Dorn. Elara is a defector from the Empire, which, even without a quest, makes her pretty cool. She's fiercely loyal to the Republic and carries around an encyclopedic knowledge of military regulations in her head. But there's more to her than the rulebook. At a certain point in the story, she'll get an urgent call from her brother, whom she hasn't seen since she defected. He tells her he's pinned down and there's no help coming. Naturally, Elara wants to rescue him, which she does. She even convinces him to defect too. And all this happens off screen, so all we can do is stand and listen to her recount her story. We think it would have been a lot more fun to go along with her to meet her brother, maybe help her convince him to defect, or if you're so inclined, try to undermine her. Either way, we just would have liked to have been more involved. Felix Aresso. Felix is one of those late arriving companions. He joins the Consular after Hoth, and as such, his storyline is short, but nevertheless, it's intriguing. Early in his military career, Felix and a fellow soldier were captured by the Empire and experimented on. Darth wanted to see if he could store the information from a holocron in a living mind. Aresso's buddy lost his sanity. Felix himself just lost some time and has no memory at all of the procedure. Many of his dialogues involve him tracking down his buddy and trying to learn what happened to them both. This would have been the perfect quest for a Consular who's all about healing broken minds and uncovering hidden knowledge. Just to imagine if we could have gone along with Felix to help him find his troubled friend. We could have offered to shield or heal his shattered mind or help Felix remember what happened. At the very least, we could have helped him lock away the holocron's knowledge so it couldn't leak out and cause him the trouble that it did his friend. Sadly, all we can do is offer encouragement as he goes about his investigation. Dr. Loken. Yes, yes, I know, the agent is blessed with having to chase down Leo's exes for her, and hey, not much is better than that, but hear me out. Semi-retired he may be, but Loken has been in the spy business a long time, and he's made a lot of enemies along the way. So it comes as no surprise when Loken tells you that someone is trying to kill him. Declining any help from you, he goes off to investigate on his own. He discovers that the culprits work for none other than the Imperial Science Bureau. Specifically, they were members of a project that he himself once headed. Along the way, he also learns how Vector became a Killick joiner. That's a lot of stuff to happen off-screen. How cool would it have been to snoop around with the old spook, uncovering yet more of the Empire's shady dealings? I mean, what could be more in keeping with the agent's story than that? As a bonus, we might have even been able to unjoin Vector. Then I wouldn't always want to throw him out an airlock. Talos Drellick. Talos is the perfect Inquisitor companion. He's an archaeologist with a passion for ancient Sith tombs, and the Inquisitor is a Sith with a desperate need for ancient Sith knowledge. Unfortunately, after he joins the crew on Hoth, we don't really put his skills to much use, but it would have been cool if we could have, and his personal quest would have been a good way to do it. You see, his old mentor has gone missing while off on an expedition, and Talos wants to find him. So he sets off exploring tombs and solving archaeology puzzles. Stuff we would have loved to have been doing right along with him. Just think of the Indiana Jones jokes. Heck, we could have possibly found some artifact or long hidden secret that could have helped with our fight with Thanaton. Oh, what could have been? Risha. Risha wants to be queen. She's got the bloodline. She's got the wealth. Now all she needs is to be accepted by her home planet's nobles. Her machinations involve an engagement to a well-respected and all-around good-hearted count. Come on, that is just brimming with possibilities for some hilarious smuggler hijinks. Imagine all the trouble we could have gotten into. Sassing nobles, picking terrible flirt lines with Risha's intended, or maybe purloining some precious house heirloom? I know, we sort of got to do all that on Alderaan, but answer me this. Can you ever have enough noble sassing? Well, there you have it. That's our list. What's yours? Which companions do you wish had a quest? Let us know in the comments, and while you're down there, why not leave a like and maybe subscribe for more. And as always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.